Maria Theresa was born in Vienna the 13th of May 1770. She was the daughter of the Holy Roman Emperor Charles VI and Elizabeth Christine of Brunswick-Wolfenbüttel. Maria Theresa was the only heir of the Habsburg throne, so her father made the Pragmatic Sanction.
Yeah, I remember when we discussed about the Pragmatic Sanction. Charles wanted to ensure the throne for his dear old girl when he died. He worked tirelessly to win support from several European powers.
Charles died and Maria Theresa was forced to take the throne when she was only 23 years old. Many European powers that had agreed to the sanction started to resist against her. Under the leadership of Frederick II, King of Prussia, an army invaded Silesia and claimed it. And other countries followed this example, and this resulted in the War of the Austrian Succession. In 1763, both monarchs signed a peace treaty in which Austria had to accept the loss of many territories.
I met Maria Theresa in kind of a difficult situation. She had something I wanted, and we had a little struggle. Even though some people think we were enemies, just because I invaded her territory, I always admired that she was a strong, independent woman.
Maria Theresa was an example of an absolute monarch. She thought she always made the right decision for her nation. She made new laws that led to social growth. She decreased the power of nobility. With this, she gained more power, and she believed that peasants must be able to sustain themselves.
First, she takes the power from us, and then she started teaching peasants. She called herself a Catholic, but she disobeyed orders from the church. Poor cardinals.
Maria Theresa was the only woman and last ruler of the Habsburg throne. During her reign, Austria reached stability in a way that they had never lived before, and she left a solid empire for the next generations.
Maria Theresa was the only monarch on her era to marry for real law.
How to fight, how to hunt,
but now I couldn't have a boy.
Excuse me, sir, we're talking about her marriage?
Yes. All that I wanted was her to be happy, you know?
She had 5 sons and 11 daughters. One of them was Marie Antoinette, future Queen of France.
My mommy is a really good mommy. She really loving and caring. May I say something to my mommy?
Sure.
Mommy, I want to be... Oh, wait. It hasn't been invented.
Her husband, Francis I, died the 18th August, 1765. Even though he was always cheating on her, she loved him, and from the day he died to the day of her own death, she wore black. Maria Theresa made a tomb for both of them when she was still alive. She was so devastated after his death that she made her son Joseph second her co-ruler because she couldn't bear it. Even she was so sad, she still looked out for her country. She made an arranged marriage between her daughter Marie Antoinette and Louis XVI of France to save her country and made an alliance between both nations.
I can never have enough children. In this, I am insatiable.